All right, I'm Rob and I'm going to give you a brief overview of the Cascadia Subduction Zone, the region in which our cruise is taking place. This cruise is just one part of an ongoing research project called the Cascadia Initiative. This is an effort to understand the geophysics of one of the country's most tectonically active regions. It involved the deployments of a number of offshore seismometers, in addition to onshore seismic and GPS stations. All of these aim to reveal more about crustal and mantle movements in the region. So where are we? This is the Cascadia Subduction Zone, which marks the region where the Juan de Fuca Plate is diving below the North American Plate. It runs roughly 1,000 kilometers from Cape Mendocino in California to the northern tip of Vancouver Island. At Cape Mendocino, the subduction zone joins up with the San Andreas Fault, which extends southwest along the west coast, and there's a different type of plate boundary in that the Pacific Plate here rubs up alongside the North American Plate, whereas remember in the Juan de Fuca Plate case, the plate is actually subducting below the North American Plate. This entire coastline is interesting to geologists and geophysicists for a number of reasons, not least its abundance of earthquake activity. We're now going to take a tour down the length of the Cascadia Subduction Zone, as if we were on board a satellite flying overhead. We start from Vancouver Island, looking south down the coast of Washington and Oregon. Within the ocean ahead of us, we see two linear bathymetric highs. These are the Explorer and Juan de Fuca ridges, at which new ocean crust is being formed. The Juan de Fuca slab moves roughly from this ridge in the northwest direction, and meets the North American Plate along the marked region. Moving south over Oregon, we pass over the mouth of the Columbia River, and reach the area covered by this cruise. As we fly further down the coast, we approach a transition between the Juan de Fuca and Gorda slab, and indeed here we see the Gorda ridge, which is topographically higher than the Juan de Fuca ridge. Finally, we pass the Mendocino Triple Junction, which marks the three-way meeting point between the Pacific, North American, and Gorda plates. One should notice that the ocean is much shallower above the Gorda and Juan de Fuca plates than it is above the Pacific plate south of Mendocino. This is because these Gorda and Juan de Fuca plates are smaller and younger and also hotter, which allows them to float higher in the mantle than the Pacific plate. We now head out into the Pacific. The crust here is very much older because it was formed far away at spreading ridges in the center of the Pacific Ocean. That's all from me for now, but stay tuned for future news from the cruise.